This is Correctional Officers in the News with your host, Lerone Coombs.
This report comes out of Arizona. Now, if you remember, last week I did a report on cells not locking in Arizona. This is from the same correctional system in Arizona where an officer gets stabbed in the chest. Now, it's not directly related to cells not locking, but it also highlights some of the dysfunction that is going on in that prison system. And I'm not talking about the officers, I'm talking about the administration is not doing what they're supposed to do. An officer got stabbed in the chest while escorting an inmate to the clinic. Now, the problem that I have with this, other than the fact that the officer was stabbed in the chest, thank goodness he did not sustain any life-threatening injuries and he's going to be okay. But the problem that we see here is that the inmate was caught with a shank 3 weeks prior to this incident and was supposed to be moved to maximum security and wasn't. Had this inmate been moved to maximum security, he probably would not have been able to get a hold of a shank, and this officer probably would not have been stabbed. When you have a department that has 1,000 cells that don't lock, you can suspect that there's other things that are going on that shouldn't be going on. In this case, this inmate fell through the cracks. He should not have been able to have access to a shank. He should have been moved, and he wasn't. Thank God, like I said, the officer is going to be okay. I also would like to make a correction from the last video. I said that Carlos Garcia was the president of the union in Arizona. He's not. He's a union representative, and he's a retired lieutenant from the department in Arizona, but he's not the president. But I think he's doing a great job. The videos that we saw last time with the officers that were being assaulted by inmates who were able to get out of their cells was leaked by some brave soul that works in that department and was able to get the videos to the media, and which brought it to, I guess, our attention, to the nation's attention, and hopefully there will be some resolution and these cells will be fixed and somebody will take a closer look at what's happening in Arizona right now. If need be, you need to have some sort of federal investigation go on or some sort of federal intervention to get these cells locked and to, you know, take a look at the way that they're running this jail, because officers are being hurt, officers are being attacked. And I would just also like to say, I like the way that the officers stuck together in Arizona. You know, even under these circumstances, even though the administration is not holding up their side of the bargain, they are not maintaining the cells properly, and they're not putting inmates in maximum security when they have shanks and things like that, officers are still standing together. You see in the videos where officers are protecting each other, even though they're outnumbered. You know, officers are fighting back, and that's what I like to see, and that's what correction is about. All of us taking care of one another, and that's what's happening in Arizona. And it's bringing out the best in these officers, but it's unnecessary, because if the administration was doing what they're supposed to do, officers wouldn't be going through these hardships right now. So hopefully the pressure will stay on the governor and the director of the Department of Correction in Arizona. I'm going to provide a link to this article, and I'm also going to provide a link to the last article about the cells not locking, so you can, you know, stay abreast of what's happening in Arizona. Hopefully something will be done. We'll keep you informed. So with that, until next time, as always, peace and stay safe.
This is Correctional Officers in the News with your host, Lerone Coombs.